Hey guys, welcome to Real Cricket tutorial videos. So today we are going to see how to bat in Real Cricket 18. As you can see, this is the playing 11 for both the teams. When we get to this screen, we are asked to choose the striker and the non-striker. So we have four types of batsmen: defensive, balanced, radical and brute. And based on their type, they all have different style of batting and strengths. For example, the defensive would be strong in defense but relatively weak in lofted shots, while the brute batsman should be your preferred choice for lofted shots. These ratings decide how effective a batsman is with respect to timing, placement and picking up the gap. So obviously, if you lose too many wickets at the top, by the time you reach the tail enders, it would be really difficult for you to score because of their low ratings. To go ahead, I'll first select the batsman I want on strike, followed by OK and then the non-striker. So we're going to start the match with the classic swipe option. With this swipe, all you need to do is swipe in the direction where you want to hit the ball. Just select loft here and then swipe in the direction where you want the batsman to hit the shot. To move the batsman, all you need to do is swipe in the direction where you want him to move. Again, when the bowler bowls, just swipe to hit the ball. For running between the wickets, once you have placed the ball where you want it to, just click on the run button and your batsman will take off for a run. I'll now take you through how to change your bat in the middle of a match. You can go to the pause menu here, click on kits, and a list of all the bats available to you would be displayed here. All these bats have their own attributes such as power, collision, timing, and durability. To choose your preferred bat, you can just click on select and that particular bat will be selected for you in the match. My favorite bat is the SS Master 9000. Let's select that for you. I'll have the SS Master Bat in my hand. I'll place my batsman where I want and then I'll select loft this time and just swipe in the direction where I want him to hit. Oh, that's a good shot and probably my favorite bat here. Now I'll show you how to play with joystick controls. To begin with, you can go to pause menu, settings, controls and select joystick. I'll also like to take you through the shot map for the joystick controls. As you can see, if you go to the help section, here is the shot map for the joystick controls. So we have the three buttons here, along with all the shots that are mapped in various directions. Let's go back to the match and I'll show you how to play with this particular control. So here you have the joystick controls. I'll try the hook shot now. I'll just place the cursor here and press on loft. As you can see, how I decided the controls was, once again, I'll go to the help section to take you through it. So you can see the hook shot here. So all you need to do is take your cursor here and press the green button, which is the loft button in this case, and play a hook. Similarly, if you want to scoop a particular delivery, you can see that you have the scoop shot mentioned here, which means all you need to do is place your cursor on top and just press the green button, which is the loft button in this case. Let's have a try. I'll place the cursor up and I'll just go ahead and loft it. Oh, there you have it. He's scooped the ball for a boundary. Now I'll show you how to play with the legacy swipe controls. The legacy swipe controls also works similar to the joystick controls, wherein instead of moving your cursor to the desired direction and pressing the button for the desired shot, all you need to do is first select the shot you would like to play and accordingly choose the button associated, and then when the bowler is about to bowl, just swipe in the direction in which the particular shot is mapped for the joystick. I'll first go and change the controls to the legacy swipe. Now, for example, for the particular kind of delivery that the bowler is chosen to bowl, I can just go to the shot map and, for example, I once again want to hit a scoop shot, which is here. All I need to do is first check which button it is linked to, then choose that particular button and swipe the screen in the direction in which that particular shot was mapped. So in this case, the scoop shot was mapped upwards and hence I swiped the screen upwards. So for example, for this particular ball, I want to hit a late cut. I'll just go and check where the late cut is mapped. The late cut is here. It is associated with the push button and I'm supposed to swipe in this particular direction. Let me try that for you. I'll select the push button and and there you have it. I've hit a late cut shot. Suppose I want to hit an advanced off drive. I'll just go here. I'll just click loft and then just swipe in the direction where I want him to hit the shot. And there you go. I have a perfect boundary. Hope this video has helped you to play the game better. Thank you.